Year 2 students, welcome back. We're at lesson 31. My name is Ella and I'm your teacher today. Now let's have a think about what we need. Well, we'll need some toys today and our learning books, something to write with and our thinking caps on. So let's get going with a number talk. We're having another look at how we subitize. So how we see numbers very quickly and know what they are. And often when we see numbers like this, we can look at it very different ways. So have a look at our number of dots here and quickly tell me how many there are. Okay. I've got these collection of dots, but I've got them four different times now because I think there's most likely many different answers that you've just called out. I'm going to show you some of the ways of thinking, and I wonder if I match one of the ways you've thought about how many are here. Okay, well, the first way we can look at this subitizing is we can look at the bottom section, the middle section, and the top. So if I can quickly look at those numbers, I can see we've got 1 and 3 and 5. 1, 3, and 5. And I can see that because I can subitize. I can see how many there are very quickly. And 1, 3, and 5, 1 and 3 make 4, 4 and 5 make 9. So I can see the total is 9. And I wonder if that's what you saw. Here's another way of looking at the subitized amounts. Let's look. So we might go 5, but instead of breaking them up in two sections, I might have seen that as a 4. So I might see this as a 5 plus 4. And you get it. We're going to get the same number each and every time because they are the same amounts. So that's two different ways we can subitize these dots. Let's have a look at a third and fourth. Okay, maybe you saw a 3, a 3, and a 3. A 3, a 3, and a 3. Same amount, 9. You're right. Or maybe, I had a little friend called Oscar who showed me this. Maybe you saw something that was missing. Maybe you saw the 5. The 3 and the 1, like here, but you saw one missing and you just knew that that would be a 5 and a 4 and a 1, which would make our magic friend 10, but you knew that one was missing. That's quite a tricky way of looking at it too, isn't it? All right, so I think we're warmed up and ready to go. Today's lesson is going to be all about measuring things. So I hope you have your things ready. Let's get to it. Today's learning intention is to measure length using informal units. What's an informal unit? Well, an informal unit might be our hands. We could measure how long things are with our hands. We might use a pop stick, might have used that before, to measure something in length, or perhaps a block. Sometimes we can put blocks together and measure with an informal unit like a block. Okay, so we know we can do this when we can place a value on a measurement of length, a number on a measurement of length. Okay, so let's just remember though that those measurements need to be a standard unit of measurement. What do I mean by that? Let's have a look at some non-standard measurements. So if I decided I was going to measure something in shells, I think you can see there might be a problem because these shells are all different shapes, sizes, and lengths. So if I told you something was measured in a shell, you might be thinking of any one of these different styles of shells. So this is a non-standard way to measure. Here's another idea. I'd like to use my trains to measure a length, but I can see that my trains are different lengths. So this is also non-standard. Okay, so today we can't use our shells or our trains that are different lengths, but we can use some things that are standard, things that look the same. So Today I'm going to choose a spoon, I'm going to choose a peg, and I'm going to choose a block. These are standard ways to measure informally my toy. Okay, let's estimate and measure our toy. Today it's Tommy Tiger. I wonder what your toy may be. And we're going to have a look at what attributes, which ways to measure our toy. So for Tommy Tiger, I could measure how heavy he is. I could measure how tall he is, but I'm not going to. I'm going to measure his length. And for me, I'm going to look at the tip of his tail and his very front paw, and that's where I'm going to measure. So to start with, I'm going to make a table, and I've already made mine to help us move along. So today, I am going to use my chart to measure the length of my toy tiger. Okay, and you can see I'm going to measure my tiger with a peg, a teaspoon, and some blocks. And I've made a place where I can put my estimate, my guess. I wonder how long my tiger will be in pegs and teaspoons and blocks. And then I'm going to show you the amount. Okay, let's get going. So, if I'm going to use the length of my tiger, I'm going to make sure I've got him all ready to go. I could use some other toys. So make sure you've got the toy of choice. And I'm going to use these measurements. Now, when I guess, I'm going to guess more of this smaller length. I'm going to guess less when it gets longer and less again. In fact, I can see a lovely relationship between these two lengths. Can you? I can see that this is almost half, or this is double. So I'm going to have a think about that when I do my estimation. And I can also see another relationship here. I wonder how many of those I can put in my peg. So when I start guessing, I'm going to start thinking about the different lengths as well. I'm going to start with an estimation. And I'll start with my peg. So if I look at my tiger and I guess how many pegs in length is my Tommy Tiger, I might pick I might pick seven. So let's write seven pegs as my estimate. Okay, not a bad estimate. Let's see how we go. So now, measuring something with an informal unit or a formal unit, we have to be very careful to measure them up carefully. So when I start, I'm going to use my longest finger to help me put it against the start point and the end point. Okay, so one, I've started here, top to toe, two, top to toe, three, four, five, six, seven, eight pegs. Well, that was a very good estimate, wasn't it? Eight pegs. So the amount of length of my toy tiger is eight pegs. Okay, here we go. Let's try our next unit of measurement. According to my table, it's a teaspoon. So let's check out how long, what's the length of Tommy the Tiger in teaspoons. Now remember, I did think about the relationship between the teaspoon and the peg, and I do remember thinking it's probably about double. So, or half, double or half. So if I've estimated seven for pegs and spoons, I might estimate somewhere around half of that. So I'm going to estimate four. I think Tommy the Tiger is four teaspoons in length. Tommy the Tiger, four teaspoons. Here we go. So remember, I'm going to make sure that it's at the end or the start or the finish of Tommy. And I'm going to use a different system this time of top to toe measurement. I'm going to flip my spoon. So watch carefully. It starts here, so there's one and flip, two and flip, three and flip, four. Four. It's a little bit just missing here. So I'm going to record that as four and a little bit. I'm not quite sure what that will be, but let's write that down. Oh, my estimate was very good. So four, this is four, but I know there's a bit more. So I'm gonna write that and a bit more. I'm not sure. Okay, so that may or may not work for me. Let's keep going. The next measurement, the way I'm going to measure the length of Tommy the Tiger, is with blocks. And we know that if I look at all three ways of measuring, I know that this is the smallest. So I think I'm going to estimate more. How much more, I think? Well, it's definitely going to be more than seven and more than four. I think I'm going to write 20. 20 blocks is a good estimate. I'm not sure, but that's a good guess and it will help me reason my answer. It will help me think my answer is going to be around about that many. Now, with blocks, this is going to take quite a while, isn't it? One block, I'm going to lie this block down as that unit of measurement at the start, make sure it's right next to Mr. Tommy Tiger's paw. And I'm going to use my blocks all the way along. This could take quite a while, so I wonder if I have any more blocks. Oh, I do. I wonder if I could use some more blocks and use that to help me. So what I think I might do is put a five blocks together and count in fives. I know I can do that, two fives and tens. So let's have a look. We've got one lot of five. Use my thumb, top to toe, two lots of five, three lots of five, four lots of five lots of five, and six lots of five, but I think I need one more. Let's see, six lots of five and one more. Six lots of five. Let's count in fives. 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, and one more. Goodness me, it is 31 blocks. So my estimate, I was guessing, was not that close to where the amount actually was. Okay, so 31 blocks. Now I know I have used all of those informal units to measure Tommy the Tiger. Which was the most efficient? Which was the best way of measuring Tommy Tiger, do you think? Let's have a look. I'm not sure about this measurement because I'm not sure what a bit more means. So I'm not sure this is the best way to measure Tommy the Tiger. And I think this one took a long time and I wasn't very good at estimating it either. So I believe that the best way to estimate and measure Tommy the Tiger was with our pegs. Eight pegs, quite an efficient way. I did it very quickly. It was accurate and I can measure Tommy that way. So next time I measure Tommy, I will go straight to the pegs. Okay. Today we were very good at learning how to measure with informal units and we learnt that to accurately measure something, it's important to use the same standard unit of measurement, the same standard like a pop stick. And we took very much great care when we lined it up. So we made sure it went top to toe, top to toe, top to toe, just like this. No gaps and no overlapping. Just like that, top to toe when we measure using informal units. Okay, well done, Mr. Tommy. Great listening today and great learning about units of measurement and how we measure things up in an accurate and efficient way. All right, so your task today is to find your favorite toy. Maybe it's a sea monster. Maybe it is a train or a long train that you can measure with something else. And maybe it's one of your favorite stuffed toys. So I would like you to go away now and draw a table. You can draw on a piece of paper or in your learning book. So let's have a think about it. We'll need a heading, the length of your toy. And we'll need three different things for you to measure, three standard measurements, okay? Informal, doesn't need to be anything more than perhaps a peg, a teaspoon or a block, or something you have where you are that is the same size, okay? A uniform or standard measurement. And of course, we always estimate. We estimate because we think about what our answer might be. So if we come up with some crazy answer, we might reason that and think, no, that couldn't be right. So we come up with what we think it might be, and then we measure using top to toe, and write our amount. And then remember, the last thing we did was we thought about, well, which was the best way? What was the most efficient way of measuring? And today we decided it was our pegs, because it just nicely measured up and we didn't have to do any more and mores, or we didn't have to do lots of. Okay, so enjoy your learning, enjoy your measuring, and I might see you for our next lesson. Bye.